Straus Project rolls on. We are at Lucky Star in Bartlett with Janet Gardner and Justin James. Thanks for joining us today.
Thanks
for having us.
You have a debut album coming out August 18th on Pavement Records. It's self-titled. First, before we get into that, I'd like to talk a little bit about how the two of you met.
All right. Well, as we are here in Chicagoland, as it turns out, we met here in Chicago. I was playing a Vixen show with Lita Ford at the Arcata Theater, and Justin and Gerald,
yes,
who's also playing in the band, were both there. So we had a nice little conversation, but we didn't, you know, nothing really happened. And we were both chicken. We were both looking at the floor, you know, hi, acting like, you know, silly teenagers.
It was quite hysterical. As soon as I saw her, just straight at my feet.
And then a year later, we played Farm Rock, which, you know, we saw you guys there.
Right.
And lo and behold, he was there again. So then, you know, we definitely had more conversations, hung out a little bit more, and then we started to just correspond here and there. And it took us a long time to figure out that, you know, maybe we were interested in each other, because we were both chicken. So it's like, oh, no, we're just friends. No, people were asking, are you two, you know, anything going on? No, we're just friends. We're just friends. So, finally, you tell the rest of the story.
Really, Justin James is going to tell a story.
Ironically, I was here with Gerald. We were just having dinner in the restaurant part, and Janet texts me and asks something about bug bites from Farm Rock. Did I get any bug bites? And I thought about it, and I knew I was interested in her, but again, just nervous, didn't want to say anything, and Gerald's coaching me. Flirt with her, say something flirty back. And I said, all right, if I write this and I don't hear from her ever again, I'm never talking to you again, and I'm going to kick your ass. So I did it. I pushed it, and she responded and came back, and things just went from there.
Yeah, I flirted back.
Yeah. And ironically, at this place where we're doing our debut show, how ironic is that?
Amazing how things work out.
Absolutely.
You never know,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
That's fantastic. You guys, I mean, you look like you guys really enjoy each other's company. So I think that would translate over into the two of you writing together. You were talking a little bit before about how quickly this release came together for you.
It did. We've talked about it. We've both being musicians and stuff, obviously contemplated it and went back and forth. But there's always that fear that one person's going to come up with an idea that the other person's not feeling. You don't want to hurt their feelings. So, you know, we kind of avoided it. And after New Year's, we sat down one night, worked on one song, and still had no idea what was going to come of it. And we were blown away by what we did. And next thing you know, a week later, song number two. And then within 5 months' time, we have a full album produced, mixed, and a record deal. I mean, it exploded fast, but we had fun doing it. We had a great time, and it was what we looked forward to every day.
He's gonna take you to the dark, and fly you up your senses. He'll break you, he'll break your soul on fire. Why don't you feel me? My only mission is to open up your
Did you dedicate specific time to doing it, or was it organic? Did it just happen naturally?
Well, we're busy. So, you know, it was different for both of us, because I'm one of those people that would stay up for 3 days straight with no sleep and just, you know, you get too far inside it and then you can't even think straight. That's kind of my method. Well, this was really good because we had other things that we had to put it away and then come back to it. And a lot of times when we would come back to it, all of a sudden the parts we were struggling with were boom. It all just kind of flowed out. So no, we didn't really, I mean, he's the whip cracker for sure. How are those lyrics coming? Well, I'm stuck. Well, let's get you unstuck. What's going on? So the good thing about us though is that, you know, one of us would get stuck and drop the ball. The other person would pick it up and run for a while and get, you know, so we both were, there was always someone
right
with a fresh perspective to go, why don't we try this?
It was nice because, I mean, we're both, you know, we both have our own style. So, I mean, it was nice to combine those two styles to see what we came up with. And yeah, one of us would come up with an idea and then the other would jump in and tweak it or whatever. And then at the end of it, it was come out great, exactly how we wanted it.
And that that comes to two people coming together with their ideas, which is probably different than the way that you two have written in the past. When you have somebody fresh and new, they bring new ideas to the table. Getting comfortable with the way that you two work, it sounds like that it was never an issue. It sounds like it clicked from moment one.
Well, the great thing is that we sort of would respect each other's vision for, you know, certain parts of a song, or, you know, if he was really set on something being a certain way, I would try to make it work with what his vision was, and vice versa. Mm-hmm. So, and that's hard to come by. A lot of times, you know, people will push their own vision onto you, and you're not comfortable with it. So I think we did a really good job of that, too, of finding common ground where we both felt really comfortable with, this is a great way to say what we want to say here. So, mm-hmm. Yeah, it flowed really, really well.
So the songs on this album, since the two of you had made these songs together, grittier, more raw, more emotional, how would you describe this release?
I would say all of that. I mean, there's definitely heavier sounding stuff on there. There's definitely true emotion in there on it, and gritty, and a lot of energy.
You're going on tour, you're doing these small little events again, and it's like you're starting over again. You have to bring the crew out, and you have to bring your band out, and you have to book dates and interviews with us. It's like starting from square one again.
Kind of. You know, I mean, we're lucky that we have people like you that, you know, are interested in finding out what we're up to with, so that's great. But yeah, I mean, I don't mind doing this. I love doing this. Especially playing new music, you know? You can go out there in front of a lot of people and play the same songs over and over again, and it's always great. You know, you're always connecting with an audience. People are singing, people are having a great time. But it's definitely great to be playing some new music, even if it's not in front of thousands of people at once. Amazing, amazing feeling.
Those intimate, you know, settings are nice, too. I mean, they offer their own bonus as well. You get to connect.
Tonight's going to be really casual, too. We're going to talk about the songs and, you know, stuff that we wouldn't necessarily do, like, at a festival in front of a few thousand people. You know, we're going to be up close and personal, explain where the songs came from, and so, yeah. Looking forward to it.
And we are too. We're looking forward to your album. It's on August 18th. It comes out on Pavement Records. And then what's left for you? What else are you guys going to do? When the album comes out, things are going to happen for you? You're going to go on tour a little bit more? Or what's left for you for the rest of 2017?
We are. We have an agent. Yep. After the record comes out, he's going to, you know, book us some small runs here and there. We're going to try to hit all different parts. They're talking about Europe. So yeah, we'll be out there playing it live.
Well, we're looking forward to this evening. Thank you so much for sitting down and taking the time with us. It's Janet Gardner and Justin James joining the Straus Project.
Hi, this is Janet Gardner
and Justin James,
and you're tuned into
the Straus Project.